Spray inks are probably not the first thing you might think of when deciding what to use when printing with a gel press plate, but the addition of gel or iridescent medium as a base layer provides a surface that the inks can sit on without beating up. In today's video, I'll explore that and how to pattern that base layer using our creative art textures. Using ink sprays on a gel press plate produces not great results. The ink has a tendency to bead up and make puddles, and if you add too much, then it really just ends up being one giant puddle of a mix of colors. Some enterprising person, and I'm not entirely certain who, figured out that if you put a layer of gel medium on the plate before you put the sprays on, it really stabilizes things. Now, you can still go overboard and use too much sprays and you basically undo what the gel medium does, but if you're careful about how much you use, then you can get some really interesting results. So this is a print that I made using some spray inks. I put the stencil, this is our endless stencil, I put it down on the surface of the plate, sprayed the color over it, lifted up the stencil, pulled this print, and pulled this ghost print. And you can see it's pretty indistinct. The pattern is there, but it's not nearly there in a way that you'd absolutely recognize it, or certainly not in the kind of results that I was looking for. So in comes some, this is Dina Wakely's gel medium, and I'm gonna put a layer of it on my gel press plate to start with. Now this is an 8x10 plate. I would say that that amount is pretty good, and you'll kind of feel your way through this as you go along. There is going to be one occasion, and we'll get there, when I'm gonna put a little bit heavier layer of gel medium on, but for the most part, this works with about what you see here. So I've added the gel medium. Now what I'm gonna do is take a stencil, and this is one of our 9x12s. It works really well on the 8x10 stencil. You get coverage over everything. So I have one color of Dylusions Ink Sprays. This is Mushy Peas, and then I have Cracked Pistachio from the Distress Spray Stain line, and I'm even gonna bring in some Lindy's because it's just another spray stain with the addition of some mica in it, and obviously they're wonderful, so why wouldn't I? So let's slip this out of the way for a moment. I'm working on just plain old printer paper today. You can certainly work on pages from our watercolor disc-bound journals. You can work on watercolor paper. You can work on Bristol paper. You can pretty much work on anything you want. So here is my initial pull, and you can see that this is far more distinct. And if I come in and pull up ghost print, you'll see that it's still distinct, although like all ghost prints, it's going to be much lighter. So I can take this off, and you can see that this is a really nice result. So why do this? Well, I like the ability to stretch my tool, which is the plate. I like the ability to stretch my stencils, which is to use them on a plate, but in a different way. And bringing in the ink sprays means I can utilize all three things that I already own. If the purpose of the gel medium is to provide a layer for the ink sprays to sit on so that they don't bead up and puddle, I started to wonder, well, what else could I use that would do the same kind of a thing? And Liquitex's iridescent medium came to mind. If gel medium simply dries clear, then the iridescent medium is just gel medium with the addition of that iridescent mica powder, whatever it is that they put in there, to provide that iridescent effect. And so with that in mind, I decided to give it a try, and you'll see that not only does it work just like the gel medium, but you get that fabulous iridescence at the same time. Now, it's not going to take much of this, so I'm just going to put a few drops out. If I need to roll a little bit off, I certainly can. But I think that this will be okay. So you can already see the iridescence on here. And while the medium, the binder that it's floating in, will dry clear, the iridescence itself is kind of a pearly white, and it's just gonna be there. It's not gonna really add anything but the iridescence to it. It's certainly not gonna add any color. So this is our leaf specimen stencil. I have vanilla custard and rose quartz Dylusions ink sprays. I'm just going to come through and spritz the color on. Now, I'm going to come back to this in a second, so I'm just going to put it off to the side for a moment and get it out of the way. Grabbing a piece of printer paper, and I'm going to print this, and then I'm going to ghost print it. So here is my first print. Now, there's color on there left over from the last thing I was playing with, but the iridescence is also there. I think you'll see it a little bit more when I pull the ghost print. This is what happens when you don't clean the print in between, clean the plate in between. You get this very serendipitous stuff that happens. And I like this, which is why I don't clean the plate in between. So you can see, now you can really see that iridescence. There was a lot of color before that kind of hit it. So the thing to remember is because the iridescent medium went on the plate first, it's going to appear everywhere in your print, not just in the openings of the stencil. So this is an alternate technique that gives you a very different look with the addition of the iridescence. So now what I'm going to do is bring in, this is the side of the stencil that has the spray on it. This is the side that was against the plate, so there's gonna be some gel medium on here. I'm just gonna grab a piece of scrap paper and I just wanna press so I get good coverage. I get all of the spray that's left on the other side of that stencil to press down onto the plate. And now I'm gonna bring in a couple of other colors. So let's bring in some green. This is Twisted Citron, and I'm gonna come back to Cracked Pistachio. All right, so now I'm gonna lift the stencil. Actually, I'm not gonna lift the stencil because this produces an interesting result. If I don't lift the stencil, I can print this and I'm gonna get this really cool print that I like a lot. Again, you're seeing all this come through because I'm just using inexpensive printer paper. So there's the first thing, which I think is freaking fabulous. So now if I take that stencil off, you'd think that all the good stuff was removed from the openings of the stencil. You wouldn't really see anything, but it does not work that way. You get a really cool print by doing this. And how awesome is that? You get the leaves, you get that background color. It's just amazing. I'm going to quickly pull a ghost print. With the addition of the medium, whether it's iridescent medium or gel medium, you do have to work reasonably quickly. This is really faint, but it's there. You do have to work reasonably quickly because it's going to want to dry very fast. Now, the thing that I've noticed, and I don't have anything super dry to show you on, the thing that I've noticed is that both the iridescent medium and the gel medium are permanent when dry. And while it doesn't make the ink sprays permanent when dry, it certainly does add a layer of protection. I have taken completely dry prints like this, misted them with water, and come in with a paper towel, and I only get the faintest amount of color that picks up. So if you're one of those people that gets disappointed when you print the first layer, which is then almost completely changed by the second one because the first layer re-wets and moves, then this is an option that will give you a little bit more control. One of the benefits of not always having time to put stuff away before you move on to the next thing is that things lie around and maybe they spark an idea. So I'm filming this video not too long after I filmed the one about our brand new creative art textures and they were still on my workbench. So I got to wondering, well, what happens if I texture the gel before I spray it or do whatever I'm going to do to it? And it occurred to me that that might actually work. So I played with it, and I put a layer of gel medium on, and I pulled a reasonably nice print. And then I thought, well, all right, so what happens if I actually add a little bit heavier layer of gel? And that's what I want to show you. This time I'm not even going to use a stencil. I just want to show you how the creative art texture works in conjunction with the gel medium to produce its very subtle, I guess, is the best way to describe it. And you'll notice that this is far more gel medium than I used, or far more iridescent medium that I used than I used. So I'm just going to slide all this out of the way and come in here and go ahead and brayer this on. All right, so here is my layer, far heavier than the previous ones were. Just going to roll that excess gel medium off. So now what I'm going to do is come in with the creative art texture, and I'm going to bring in a piece of scratch paper here. You're not going to see anything. All I want to do is once I press the rubber into the gel medium and it lifts it up, I need to be able to stamp it off so that the next press actually makes a reasonably good impression, because if you go back there with gel medium on it, you're not going to lift as much the second time. So I'm only going to do this twice because I only want to impress the texture into half of the gel. So let's just go ahead and stamp that off and then just get that out of the way. So this time I have a couple of Lindy's. And what I'm going to do is, this is my texture. I'm not going to do anything to the other side. I'm just going to spritz this on here, pull a print, and then pull a ghost print, and you'll see how interesting this is. As I said, it's really subtle, but it's kind of fun. And why wouldn't you? You do try to experiment and do all kinds of wonderful things. Again, I want to reuse the stuff that I kind of already have. Now, I'm not pressing super hard here because that layer of gel is textured and I don't want to alter what I just put in it. So when I pull this out, isn't that awesome? You can see just that little bit of texture on there. It looks very different because it's of the way that you're applying the various products. So let me go ahead and pull a ghost print now. And again, you'll see the same thing, just it's going to be a lighter version of it. But using the gel medium like this with the Creative Art Textures is just another way to use the things that you already have. So again, I get this really fun, really subtle texture, and I'm going to pull one more print out of here because I think that I can get something. And I'm always looking for things to make my art look different, and again, you can see there's not much going on here. The texture is pretty subtle there, but if nothing else, it becomes a background or the beginnings of a background that I can use. So, as I said in the beginning, ink sprays and a gel press plate are normally not best buddies, but when you incorporate gel medium or iridescent medium into the mix, you provide that layer that you can apply them to that provides that nice, stable surface to print from.